Creating a high converting landing page shouldn't be taking you that much time, but it needs to be solid. You need to have a template that you can replicate over and over again so that you're better able to test products quickly. I'm gonna show you my winning template that I've used for all my general stores in the past, and I'm also gonna show you one of my winning products of last year's 2019 winter that absolutely dominated on a general store, and I took it and I made an entire store based off of it and crushed it. If you wanna win a free 30-minute consulting call with me where I go over your store, your products, or whatever it is you need help with, all you gotta do is drop a comment, like, and subscribe. I just want to hear your feedback. That's the whole point of this. So send me a message on Instagram if you need some help or whatever it may be, or drop a comment if you have any questions, and just like and subscribe, and I'll pick from the winner and I'll announce it in the following video. Okay, no more time to waste. Let's get right into this banger. Guys, be sure to watch this video until the end because I'll also be going over the actual description copy itself, which is just as, if not more important than the template, because you have to be a good salesman when you're writing your descriptions. And I'm gonna show you guys some good tips and tricks on how to do this. Also, I'll be revealing the winner of last video's free 30-minute consulting call sometime in this video. So definitely stay tuned until the end of it so you can see if you're a potential winner. All right, guys, let's get it started. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reveal to you the actual product itself on AliExpress, and then I'm actually gonna tell you guys the kind of research that we first need to do very briefly, very quickly. It just takes a second on Amazon, product research for ourselves to actually know how to write the description, because if you don't do this step, then you're gonna write a pretty bad description. But if you do this step, you're honestly gonna write a pretty amazing description, and a lot of people miss out on this. They don't really know about this little secret, guys. So definitely follow this video to the T. Next thing we're gonna do is actually go into Shopify on one of my old stores and write the description itself and show you guys how I lay it out. And I'm also gonna go through each and every single paragraph and explain to you, along with the titles, why I've chosen to pick this title, why I've chosen to pick this paragraph, this image. Everything is done strategically. I want you guys to learn. I don't just wanna give you something that you're just gonna copy and paste. You guys need to understand why we're doing this. So let's take it step by step and dig right in and show you guys the product reveal. All right, guys, this is the product. It's the heated vest. You've all seen it. It's a super saturated product now, but it still actually does pretty well every winter. I still test this product and make a few bucks out of it. But you know, 2 years ago it was dominating. So we're gonna just take this product and show you guys how I actually kept it going even during a saturated market, how I was able to test it on a general store when this product really came out in 2017 and it was killing it then, and it still kills it every winter. So definitely keep this in your back burner and learn from it if you want to replicate this kind of method. But I want to teach you guys what we're doing first. So we have this product right in mind, and what we're going to do first is actually go to Amazon and search for the product. It's a heated vest. So you search for it and you find a lot of different listings for it. But first we want to actually find one that's pretty decent and has a lot of reviews and a good rating to it, because we want to learn from the customer feedback. That is the key. That's the secret sauce, guys. What the customers say is so much more important than actually what the store owner says, what the listings person says. Because look at this. The first thing that they tell you is it's 100% nylon. Who cares about that? No one. You want to know about the benefits. You want to know what it's done to a customer. This is such an important step, and it only takes like 10 minutes worth of reading. Go to the review section right away and we're going to read the reviews. Now, granted, there are some bad reviews out there, but if the product overall has a good rating, 4.7 out of 5, that's awesome. If it's above 4.3 on Amazon, you're in the green there. So this product, of course, is not exactly the one on AliExpress, but it has the same function. So if the one on AliExpress works, then of course you can have the same kind of idea, the same concept, and drag it onto your store. Actually, before we get into the reviews, real quick, I want to note that you can actually take these images when you're testing. It's okay to actually copy. I don't 100% condone it for copyright reasons, but if there's no copyright associated with it, then you can actually just take it, copy and paste, or save these images and use it for yourself, because they look super professional. All you have to do is quickly go on Photoshop and just take out this little logo and done. You're good. Use these professional images during your testing phase so you can really understand whether the product is good or not. Because if you have shitty images from, let's say, AliExpress like this, like, what is this? This is nothing. This is not appealing at all. Why would you want to use those if you have this? So you can use this to test and not put a lot of money into getting your own content in the beginning, because these guys already did that for you. So use these pictures to test it. Once you have proof of concept and the product works, then you can move on to actually developing your own content, your own images, your own videos, etc. So let's get right to the reviews and understand a little bit about it. So I'm not going to read through all of this. I've already done a lot of research on this. I know what this product has to offer. I know that the product actually gives you quite a bit of warmth from all around, all sides of it, including the neck, the chest, the back. It's a great product. It's actually also wind resistant. I know that some customers are out in cold places like Montana or the prairies in Canada, and they really like to use products that keep the ultimate warmth inside of their layers. Obviously they're wearing a jacket, but this product is for you to stay warm all throughout. It warms your core temperature so that you're able to have warmer limbs and better blood circulation, and customers talk about that here. So I took note of that. I wrote, basically what I do is I write half a page to one page on a doc, on a Google Doc, with comments, little fact that I've uncovered, a little opinion that I've uncovered that helps to provide the benefit for the product, helps to purvey the benefit of the product to my consumer. This is market research. You have to do this. It just takes 5 to 10 minutes. Quickly skim through everything. You don't need to read about a customer talking about how it fits so nicely on Sally or whatever. Talk about the heat around the back of the neck is nice. That's important. But these things are very important. The zippers seem cheap. Okay, maybe they're cheap zippers, whatever, fine. Anyways, let's move on. All right, guys, here is the product page that I used way back. All right, so first off, I'm gonna cover the apps that I used within Debutify that helped. These are not necessary, but they really did help with my conversions. And this one is simply a selector instead of the drop down. That, in my opinion, helps a lot. You also want to limit your options. Unfortunately, this is a clothing product, so I had a lot of options. Quantity breaks. This one is very clean as opposed to the chart style that you usually see in most descriptions. It looks ugly that way. This one is very good. It's right on top of the add to cart, so you can see the savings that you can make. People don't buy more than 4, so I only left it at 4 because it's just a vest, right? So anyways, and if they want, they can just keep adding to cart. Buy now button right under it. It's a dynamic checkout. You can have PayPal as well on there, or Amazon Pay, and it looks better. It increases conversions because it looks more legitimate. People trust those things. Right under the add to cart in my future websites, I actually have a little lock icon and then SSLL checkout secured text right underneath it. It helps with conversions as well, but this is not gem pages, so we couldn't do that, and that's okay. All right, so I'm gonna go through the template real quick. So first off, we have a title here, right? And then we have a paragraph and then an image, and that's generally what we're going for. It's a repetition of this kind of format: title, paragraph, image, title, paragraph, image, etc., etc., etc. And it goes all the way to the bottom, right? And then we have additional features, because features are not that important. They're on the bottom. All right, if people want to know more about this product, they can scroll down to the bottom and see it there. Benefits go first, tying emotion goes first. Features like the material of the product, the specifications, all of that stuff can go later on in the end. It is not that important. You can neglect it for now. This page in particular is rather long because of the type of the product. It has a lot of functionality to it. Therefore, I made it long. However, please note that the title is essentially all they need to read. If they read the titles only, they'll completely understand what the product does. They don't need to read the paragraphs. However, if they want to get nitty gritty and learn more about the features, they're more than able to read the paragraph and learn a lot more and be sold even more. Now, the last thing that I put right before the little drop downs is ship with care, or ship with whatever, or like something a little bit about your company, right? Something else out there. I'll put an image of a 3D mockup of my brand logo. Obviously, I haven't put it here, but I would do that generally. It helps with conversions because they see the 3D logo. Like, for example, it could be a 3D mockup of your brand logo on an office wall. That'll make it look super legitimate. Or maybe it's in a shipping warehouse. That'll make it look even better. So you can find 3D mockups online. I have a video on this as well. Check out my history and you'll see it. And then in the bottom, I'll have customer reviews. But before customer reviews, I haven't put it here in this page, but you'll see little drop downs that show shipping time. Like drop downs you can click on right underneath this image. It'll show shipping times or shipping details. It'll show return policy, and it'll also show specifications of the products. So customers are able to click on those and read about it, and they have no excuse as to understanding what your shipping times and policies were, because it's on the product page, it's on your website, it's everywhere, it's in your confirmation emails. You're good to go. So let's go back up and let me cover why I've selected these images. So this one is clean. It's super clean image, and it's a white background. It looks very fresh with this. All the colors are congruent, right? It matches with my website's theme as well. It's very clean, and that's what you want. You don't want an image like, for example, this. Like, what the heck is that? Or even this, you know, it just looks kind of unreal. But something like this even can be good, right? A model wearing the actual product. And so what we want to have for these kind of this carousel pictures is essentially people, you know, just showcasing some of the features, showcasing what the product looks like, right? That's essentially it. The rest of it, the main images you want to put in your description. Do not replicate, do not duplicate the images. If you're having images in the carousel, make them separate from the images in the description. Now let's move on to the actual ad copy itself. So again, it's title, paragraph, image. Right, so for the first image, I generally would like to use a GIF. If I have a video that I've made for the ad itself, then I'll take part of the video and make it into a GIF. This part in particular was perfect because it actually matches with what kind of description I want to provide as well. It provides full coverage heating, and that's important. So I've noted that for superior warmth, warmth is very important. Stay comfortable. Stay comfortably dry, heated, and stylish while wearing our latest innovation in thermodynamic heating. What does this sentence say? This says that we are actually developing this in-house is what it looks like. It's as if we're a professional team who made this product, even though it's a general store. People trust this brand now, right? So I've named this Broxer. Obviously, this isn't my store, but I'm going with Broxer for now. So they think Broxer made this technology, right? Our vest is a perfect layer for maintaining an optimal core temperature, right? An optimal core temperature is important for the most brutally cold of windy days, right? So that's really taking home, taking the customer back to the idea of like, oh man, they're remembering it gets really cold outside, especially when it's windy. I gotta avoid that. Keeping an optimal temperature helps. That's awesome. And this product does that. So this paragraph was very powerful. Total coverage heating for superior warmth. That's very powerful. The image itself following it relates to it. It gives a congruency to it. It makes it look legitimate. That's very important. No more limb freezing numbness. That itself is very emotion driven, right? You can relate to this. Your customer can relate to this. When you read the Amazon reviews, you'll see this kind of text in the reviews because they're like, oh man, my hands are always cold. My arms are cold. But when I have this vest on, it heats my core temperature and it actually heats up my extremities as well. So this really helps with that. Broxer heat technology keeps your blood flowing strong to maintain warmth across your face, hands, and feet. Stable and warm core body temperature allows your extremities to stay heated to avoid freezing numbness feeling in your limbs. Remind the audience of the pain because this product solves that pain, right? That's what the point of this product is. If your product solves stress, pain, saves time, makes money, whatever helps you with your athleticism, you want to really drive that in. Problem solving factors are so more important than features. And we also want to tie those problem solving factors with emotion, but as well with features too, because you don't want to drive on the features, you want to drive on the benefits, which actually derive from the features. So benefit first, followed by the feature. This happens because of this feature, not this feature causes this benefit. You see how I turn that around? So important to do that, guys. Again, an image. This is a very good image because it just shows like, hey, we got professional photos, professional models. We out here, we got money to spend. This is a legit brand. You got nothing to worry about. Don't go to the homepage, ain't nothing there. That's the vibe, right? So we want to go with that professional style.
Everybody stop what you're doing, it's vibe check time.
All right guys, sorry for the interruption. I'm going to announce the winner of last video's free 30-minute consulting call giveaway. And the winner is Jir Lubok. Hit me up on IG, man, send me a DM and we'll schedule a time to meet. If you guys want to also win, all you have to do is like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll pick at random who the winner is. And we'll talk about anything you want. I'll help you out with anything it is. And let's get right back to the video. That's the vibe, right? So we want to go with that professional style. Relieves muscular tension and improves blood flow. Another benefit, right? Because it improves blood flow. It's a heat pad on your body that you're wearing throughout the whole day. Of course it improves blood flow. It's nerve calming heat therapy. Highly effective for 91% of our patients suffering from muscular discomfort. Of course, now in the beginning, I might use this kind of fact that might not be completely true, but I looked it up for other products that are similar and I took it from them. And I pasted it on here just like I did with Amazon. But when you actually establish your own brand from a winning product, you want to be more legitimate. You don't want to BS your way through it. So in the beginning, this is okay. Our one-of-a-kind vest is optimized for muscle relaxation therapy and increased blood circulation. Broxer's several heating pads found on the back, front, and neck of the vest provide for nerve calming heat therapy that is proven to be highly effective for 91% of our patients suffering from muscular discomfort or pain. Now, again, pain solving, discomfort solving. You have heat on your neck. It's warm, it's fuzzy, it's nice. It really drives that home and it shows it in this picture, right? Several heating options to control your temperature. Again, now this is just going towards the features more so because it's towards the bottom of the actual page. Never worry about, but again, I drive back to the benefits. Never worry about staying warm. Again, keep your body functional during the coldest of days. Bolded. So if they only read the bolded parts, they completely understand this whole product. They understand all the benefits. They don't need to read the rest of the paragraph or anything else. Premium blend of down cotton, the materials that are used in the actual vest, right? Superb protection against the cold, lightweight comfort, and versatile layering. The Broxers heated vest can be worn underneath additional layers or above clothing to fit your style and provide premier warmth. So not only is it warmth, it's also style, it's also layering. It's also wearing it underneath and over your clothes. You have a lot of options with this product, guys. You can do a lot of things with this, a lot of benefits solved, and a lot of stylistic things involved as well. So it's superficial too. Moving on, we have a great picture that I used here. All of this is found online. I didn't make a single one of these. I might have edited it or photoshopped a little bit, but that's it. Again, you know, it shows the quality of the product, the close-up of it, additional features, right? I also noted that here it's powered by a USB bank, portable charger is not included. So that's the catch of the product, and they need to know about that, right? So I put that somewhere in the features. Otherwise, we couldn't actually ship this with the battery until I got an agent involved with the product, because AliExpress and CJ actually don't do that. You need to get an agent to get a custom order like that with a particular battery pack, which is also very cheap. Anyways, let's get to that later on. Again, ship with care. All orders are carefully examined and packaged by our quality assessment team prior to shipping. This way, Broxer ensures supreme quality for all of our loyal customers. We care about you. That's all that says. That's important. And then right after this, I would have my own logo, a professional stylistic 3D mock-up of my logo on a wall, on an office wall that looks super pro. Of course, they're gonna be like, yeah, this is a legit store. I'm all in. Now, I've covered this page with you guys, and there's actually a lot more details I'll cover in other videos, but this is the general gist of it. You wanna take this template and run with it. Customer reviews will be an entire other video, because that's a skill on its own. But I want you guys to really take home two things. Make your templates streamlined. Make it easy for you to test products quickly. You should not be wasting time constantly making pages with gem pages. Screw that. Just use the basic themes like Debutify and just copy and paste your templates and change up the words. Take from what you see on Amazon. It'll make it easier for you guys to learn how to write your descriptions, because you'll be inspired by people who actually write good things about your product. So you're genuinely speaking about your product. That's important. They talk about benefits. They don't just talk about the features. They're not just like, hey, this is 100% nylon. Nylon is dope. No, they're like, hey, this is actually a really good material because it keeps me warm, because I'm actually not suffering in the cold with my limbs freezing. That's why customer reviews are so important. And again, we'll cover how to write the reviews on different applications on the product page itself later on. And I'll also have a video made on how to do this kind of thing for gem pages when your product takes off and you're ready to build a one product or niche store with it. But the idea is you want to test this product quickly. You want to learn how to write your descriptions, and you can't do that when you first start off writing one product stores and niche stores. No, you need to learn by practice, repetition after repetition on general stores, and that's why general stores rock, and that's why they're number one for when you're starting, especially even if you're below a year in experience. Stay with a general store, keep a template, follow the reviews, do your market research, and keep on testing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's all I got for you today. Thank you for watching until the end. Again, as always, I'm blessed for having subscribers like you, for really staying in tune with my videos and liking, subscribing, and showing feedback. This channel is growing so fast, so I'm very happy with it. Any questions, any comments, anything you guys want me to talk about, please drop it in the comment section or send me a DM on Instagram. My Instagram is in the description. And that's it, guys. That's all I got for y'all. Stay hustling, stay grinding, and never, ever, ever give up, y'all. Peace. All right, and real quick, I just want to announce that I'm sorry, but I have to stop doing daily videos. I'm going to be doing videos every other day. I just launched my fourth business this month, and it is absolutely insane how much work there is to do. Several employees to train and many more to actually take care of. So guys, I'm sure you understand. I'll be dishing out actually better quality content this way, because I'll have more time to prepare. It's just been so hectic doing videos like that. 44 videos back to back for 44 days was pretty insane. And it was a great challenge. And I'm sure I'll be up for it later on once I have things more streamlined. But for now, I'll be dishing out videos a little bit less frequently, but they'll be better quality videos. I'm sure you guys will enjoy it and understand. Otherwise, if you got any questions, send me a DM or drop a comment. Love y'all.